talked about the importance of designers learning 3D fashion software in this video. But what I wanted to do today was give you an overview of some of your software options that are available to you and what people are using in the industry. Now, this is by no means a complete list of all of your options, but these are the ones that I hear people talking about the most. And regardless of which software you decide to go with, I encourage you to email and call the companies and ask as many questions as you need to before you purchase, particularly because some of the software can be a little expensive.
Let's start with the big three. These are the three companies whose names you'll hear most often in corporate. And those are Browzwear, Optitex, and Clo. Let's discuss Browzwear first. Browzwear is one of the pioneers in 3D software for fashion. That's pretty helpful when you consider that most 3D software has been used for gaming and film, not fashion. Browzwear has several modules, including V-Stitcher, Loda, Style Zone, and Fabric Analyzer, which help the entire design and production team design, fit, merchandise, and present the product. Each module assists and allows for collaboration throughout the entire design process, which helps to reduce the number of styles and SKUs that get sampled but then eventually dropped. Another great thing about Browzwear is that the software is cross-platform and can be used on Windows or Mac-based computers. One of the few drawbacks of Browzwear is that it's mainly available only if you're working for a corporate company. They do have an indie program, but you have to apply and be accepted. Next, there's Optitex. What I love about Optitex is that the company's background is in 2D, 3D CAD software, specifically for fashion design. What's also great is that they focus on pattern and fit. They do have 3D visual software, but their focus is on developing superior tools that help you perfect your patterns. And there are tools for market making as well, which is essential for when you're ready to go into production. Now, for an apparel designer, this could be a drawback. Granted, the software can generate 3D assets, but if your focus is on presentation and design of the product, you may want a software that focuses more on that. Another drawback is that it only works on a PC. So for all of us Mac users, unless we have a spare PC lying around, this software is not an option. As far as price, it's not bad, but it's significantly more than Clo for an individual contractor or a new business. The least expensive option I discussed with a representative comes to about $1,000 plus per quarter. In the grand scheme of things, that's actually not terrible, especially when you consider that the program will help you save time and money making less samples. And then there's Clo. And what I love about Clo is that it seems to have had the designer in mind and is great when you're presenting your work. If you look into the company's history, the creator developed the program because of his passion for cloth simulation. The first evolution of the software became Marvelous Designer, popular in the CGI and gaming industry. But they eventually wanted to get back to developing a program that was specifically for the fashion industry, which was the initial vision and intent. Hence, Clo was developed. And it definitely does an excellent job of creating a virtual simulation of your designs, which not only allows you to get buy-in on the design from your merchants, but it can also allow you to show designs to customers, if your business is direct to consumer, before you ever have to cut an actual garment. You're even able to do virtual fashion shows. Another great thing about Clo, it's cross-platform, so you can use it on a PC or a Mac. One potential downside of Clo is that its roots are not in fashion, they're in gaming. Of course, Adobe's roots aren't in fashion either, and pretty much the entire fashion industry has adopted it. In terms of costs, Clo remains one of the least expensive options. As an individual designer, you can get a license at $50 a month or pay $450 for the year. They also offer student discounts and separate pricing if you need multiple licenses for larger organizations.
Like I said at the beginning of this video, this is by no means a complete list of all of your 3D options. And I have two honorable mentions. The first is Tukatech. And someone had mentioned them in the last 3D video I did, Shout out to Lana Dean Renee, and I hope I'm saying your name right, but thank you so much for mentioning Tukatech. I knew them for pattern making software, but I had no idea that they had branched out into 3D software. Now, if you are truly serious about an end-to-end solution for your apparel business, Tukatech has got you. They're very focused on fit and have really perfected and continue to perfect the art of virtually fitting a garment. Their software can include 3D body scanning, design and development tools, laser cutting. They can also recommend local factories that use their tools. And what you're seeing right now is the Microfactory they created at Magic to show how all of this works. Crazy, in a great way. I'll leave a link to the video below so you can see it for yourself. But of course, all of this wonderfulness comes at a price, which is around $40,000. And even the month-to-month option requires a $10,000 upfront commitment. Is it worth it? Probably. Because as I said, it's an end-to-end solution, and any help that you need, they will support you. But if you are a new small business, even $10,000 is a lot to invest into one product. The other thing I didn't love is that their patterns are proprietary. So if you're looking for another vendor to work with, they would also have to have the Tukatech software. And their software is not cross-platform. It only works on a PC. The second honorable mention is Rhino. And if you design footwear, jewelry, accessories, this is probably your best option. It's cross-platform, and in terms of price, you can buy it outright for around $1,000. And if you're a student or a faculty member, it's around $200. One really great thing about choosing any of these options is that you are helping to build a more sustainable fashion industry. Incorporating 3D technology helps to cut down on excessive sampling, carbon emissions because you're flying less back and forth overseas, and excess inventory, which means less clothing ends up in landfills. So which 3D fashion software is best? Well, the question really is, which 3D fashion software is best for you? And that's really based on your needs and your budget. Thanks for watching today's video. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share it if you found it helpful. Have a great week, and I'll see you next time.